stop whatever you are doing right now and let's listen to Ma'am Lucas. A big round of applause.
Okay, good afternoon. Yes, we're back. Are you doing fine? So we are in classroom management, and classroom management can be divided. There are different ways of looking at classroom management, but we can simply divide it into three based on the resulting environment from the way you manage your class. So the first one is physical. So the way you arrange your learning environment will result to the kind of physical learning environment that you have. Because it will be so easy to convince you why children are curious. Because children will also do that. And you did it. So in classroom management, the physical environment will influence the behavior of the children in the class. So it's very important to structure the environment properly. Ayun na yung example ko. Eh kung lagusan na ganun, di magtatakbo talaga yon. Okay? You do not put long hallways inside hallways, meaning long pathways in your classroom. Because that will invite children to run. Right? You have to break the spaces. The space and the way you structure the environment, no, will matter a lot. So you'll see if you change something in the environment, it will also change the behavior of the children. No? Just like the presence of the flowers change your behavior. No? So you look at all the aspects of your physical environment. The next one would be the temporal. So temporal would pertain to the time. So the way you allot time, the way the teacher allots the time, of course, this is already, you're given already the guideline, how many minutes per class, right? So how that is managed will affect the behavior of the children. Okay? Example, homeroom. Kasi waiting, no? Pambansang awit, homeroom, and then values ed, edukasyon sa pagpapakatao, 7:25 to 7:55. Then 7:55 to 8:45, mother tongue. Okay, from edukasyon sa pagpapakatao, shifting to mother tongue, how will that be done? Okay? Do you just say, okay, keep that. Okay, mother tongue na tayo. Hindi, di ba? You would have, what would you have? Transitions, yes. So the way transitions are managed, how do they move from one subject to the next? Yes, gradual. And this can all be part of the routines. How will you start instruction if you have 30 or 25 kindergarteners? You saw the picture earlier, we only have about 12 or 15. So, iba rin, no? That's why when you see, those with more students are very good in classroom management. No? They're able to really establish routines, except that, okay, sometimes teacher can overdo the routines. Ha? Huwag naman yung buong taon pareho yung kanta. It's good to give children routines, but to really explain to them when this is done, when this is used. Because if the teacher makes a mistake and points and the children respond automatically, I think there is something wrong there. No? Kasi masyadong nagiging hindi nag-iisip, masyadong behaviorist. No? Very behaviorist. Stimulus response, stimulus response. We don't want the children to be like that. Right? Kaya minsan, anong gagawin? Ikaw, anong gagawin mo? Yun na rin ako. Parang everything is, we want children to think, no? So although routines are very important, the key there is for us to explain to them. Okay? Now, I have examples here, no? Like rules, okay? Like this, in our classroom, we will listen, share, love, follow, be happy. Okay, what do you notice with this? Is this thumbs up, thumbs down? Thumbs up, very good. Yeah, kaya nga I won't explain everything. I want to see. Why is this thumbs up? What are the good points of the rules? It's simple. Kiss siya, di ba? Keep it short and simple. It's short and simple. Okay? It covers listening. What else? Listen, share. How are they stated? One word. So they're very concise. And okay, yes, it has pictures. Each rule, why? According to Jerome Bruner, children learn to represent in three different ways. No? One is, the earliest would be inactive, meaning children like to move. No? And the second is iconic. They look at pictures. And the third most advanced one is symbolic, where they use words, because words are symbols. So here, this is for the younger children who will be helped. If they cannot read this right away, they will be helped looking at the pictures. So the pictures serve as the cue. Okay? Now, can you also do this? You put inactive mode here, because this is iconic, this one is symbolic. Can you have the student of mine who presented this also has inactive version? How can we say listen through movement? Listen, share, love, follow, be happy. Okay, in the morning, can you review the rules with them? With actions? Yes. So that is one way to process. Will you have this in the classroom during the first day? Yes or no?
My answer is no, getting from the word first day. Because on the first day, we should allow our children to explore the room and then feel that they are really part of the room. So rules should be set aside first. So the following day, again, because of establishing consistency, insistency, and persistency, that's the time that we will start with at giving a bit of the rule.
Okay, so your justification is that you let them explore first before having the rules. Okay. Another reason why you should not have this during the first day.
We shall involve the kids like in establishing the rules in the classroom, especially in the kinder grades 1, 2, and 3 probably. Is we are involving everyone. So the first day, I guess, will not be a time to display that.
So the reason, it's also right, no? You don't immediately have rules on the first day because you want them to explore. But that is the reason, really. Because when you have rules, it is something that you involve the children with. It's something you process with the children. Okay? Those with teenagers, you know this will not work also with teenagers if you say, ganto ang curfew, bawal ang ganyan. It won't work. Kasi wala man lang akong say, ganon, no? So, for children, you already have it in mind. Listen, share. But part of the sessions that you will have in the first few days is to talk about the rules. So, okay, you know, we will be together every day. And when the teacher is talking or if John is talking, what will we do? What will we do? And one child will surely say, listen. Oh, Jenny, you are right. Jenny says we should listen. sabi ni Jenny, makinig. Tama si Jenny. You see, inuulit ko, no? Yung, what am I doing? I am reinforcing Jenny for volunteering to say the rule. How will Jenny feel? Happy. Will she own the rule? She will. Is she likely to follow that? Yes. Because she owns the rule. She was the one who suggested it. Do you agree with Jenny? Ganyan sasabihin mo, tama ba si Jenny? Makikinig. Gano'n naman sila lahat. Kasi hinanda mo na yun eh, kung paano mo ipoproseso. But instead of just saying, these are the rules, okay, number one. Mga bata naman. But if you have a conversation and you process it with them, it will be so clear. They will really understand the rules and they will accept it. No? And it's so good to see children talking to each other. Rule number one. Minsan gaganyan na lang sila. Listen. Kasi yung rule number one, some would put numbers because the later on, that's another symbol. Right? And you will really see the children. Gumaganyan lang sila and they talk to each other. They enforce the rules on their own. No? Why? Because the teacher processed the rules with them. No? It's not good if during the first day, the children are overwhelmed with all your posters. Sometimes they get so excited, the teachers get so excited, they decorate the classroom and all of the posters are there. Eh kung yung bata, first day ever, hindi nag-daycare, walang preschool experience, kinder, pagpasok niya, ano yan, ano yan, ang dami, nakaka-overwhelm. No? So, hindi rin natin i-overdo yung classroom. It doesn't mean the teacher will not make. Hindi pa lang niya ikakapit. Kasi plano niya yun eh, sa first week or first 2 weeks. No? Plano niya yun. Oh, kahapon pinag-usapan natin. Eto, gumawa si teacher ng poster. Anong sabi ni Jenny? Makinig. Ayan, nilagay ni teacher, makinig. Pangalawa, teacher! Sino yung magtataas? Yung nag-suggest nung pangalawa. You get it? No? They will own the rules. And they will be so excited. Teacher, acknowledge what we said and place it on the poster. No? Rather than just looking at it in the poster, it doesn't mean anything to them. No? You're making them memorize the rules. But if you process it, unti-unting napupuno ang classroom. At bawat isang poster doon may meaning sa bata. Kasi prinases sa kanya yon. No? So that's how we do it, no? So yung iba naman ginagawa naman nila na ano naman ING naman. Looking eyes, ganun, parang ganun din. Looking eyes, listening ears, pwede rin para mas action. Action 'yan, action. Listening ganyan, no? Okay? So is this laminated? Is it? No. No, it's not. No? So I'm sure maybe you do this. You lie them all flat on the plastic cover and then you put scotch tape all over at the back and then you cut it along the scotch tape. So tawag namin dyan instant laminate kasi mahal mag-laminate, no? So you just like lay them all flat and then put scotch tape on the sides. And when you cut it with the plastic, then it will really look something that can stand the whole year. No? Because if you just put it in cartolina and then it's done, no? In the first week. Okay, so this is similar, except meron uli siyang pictures. Keep quiet, use your walking feet. Okay, so it's very interesting if you do this in mother tongue. Simple words that they can readily understand and would sight read immediately. Right? Mababasa agad nila yon in mother tongue because you always review the rules. And then another important routine is the attendance chart. Because sometimes it takes really a long time and the children become rowdy once you're checking the attendance and there are so many children, no? So this is one way. So, paano ba to sa Filipino? Sino ang? Yan. Sino ang narito ngayon? Who are here today? Okay. And then you have a picture of a home. And then below, the picture of the school. So when they arrive, they will just get their picture and transfer it to the school. Because now they are in school. Do you see the integration you can do here? What subject area can you integrate here? Math, definitely. Because they can count how many are at home, how many are in school. Okay? So that's one way. And you know one way for children to feel good about being in school? You ask for the picture ahead of time. Or maybe take the picture yourself. Oh, yan ang kinuna ni teacher na picture, oh. Nilagay niya dyan. And it will really make, you know, start a sense of community in the school. No? Teacher values me. Mahalaga ako kay teacher. No? Nilagay nila ang picture namin. No? And so, tinuturuan na natin sila, hindi ba yung iba nagbabandiklak? Oh, ito yung routine. They go, they get, and transfer. Yan. Okay? So, this is one form of the attendance chart. Okay, this one is, yan. Ito, ganun din po ito, no? May korte-korte pa yan. Pero, nilagay niya sa, binaliktad niya ganun sa plastic cover and then scotch tape all around. You see? And then cut it along the scotch tape. So when you look at it, it's so sturdy. It won't tear easily. No? Okay? So this is, oh, all the children are smart in this class. Why are we smart? We speak gently. We make friends. No? Okay, nasa internet ko. Nasa internet ko. This is really nice. Because you have an acronym, and then it even has try your best, which is really a motivating rule. No, it's not just tahimik ka, makinig ka, try your best. It's a rule in this class. You always try your best. Okay? And again, kasi what we do in class, they present this and then we critique. So this is good because again, symbolic and then iconic. Yes. So children will immediately associate. You want to build a community of learners, as we discussed in DAP, so each one can have responsibilities. No? So, my duty. So, anong pwede natin? Ano nga ba to sa Tagalog? Gawain. Or tungkulin, yes. And then you can put them. Ayan kasi busy bees, di ba? Masisipag ang mga bubuyog. No? Ayan. Pwede rin yan magbago. Kaya niya ginawang natatanggal. Kasi kung ang team mo naman ay animals or community helpers, pwede ka naman gumawa ng baker. Mga ganon, no? Para may pagbabago. So, yung board mo hindi nagbabago, yung mga ilalagay lang sa loob. Wag naman buong ano, bubuyog, pinag-uusapan nyo, community helpers, bubuyog pa rin. Pwedeng magpalit, siguro every quarter man lang. Myself, my school, something like that. According to the themes. Or in grades 1 to 3, well, maybe you can really think. Maybe, pwede na to. Stay as a bee, because the bee is busy. No? Pwede yan. Pero kung sa younger ones, well, you can offer variety. Nandun yan sa PowerPoint ko. Offer variety. So, what will this teach children? Everyone has a role to play inside the classroom. So, everyone matters. yan ang mga big ideas. No? Yan ang mga big ideas na hindi nile-lecture. Nakikita sa practice na ginagawa ng teacher. Ay, ako ang mag-aano ngayong araw. So, taking turns. No? Kahapon siya online leader, ngayon ako. So, they learn to follow. This one is the routine, daily routine chart. The children behave better if they can predict. That's the principle. If children know what will happen next, they are more at ease. They know malapit na umuwi, lalo na sa umpisa. No, they will be calmer. They will not be anxious. Okay? So the purpose of this is to show the routines, right? Okay? What else? This also serve as timer. Galing. Nakasulat ba? Hindi. Ah, kasi may oras. Okay. The bigger children can understand the clock, right? The smaller ones cannot. Okay? Pero timer din to sa kanila. Bakit? They convert time to distance. Sa maliliit na bata, hindi nila alam yung temporal, yung minuto. Say mo, okay, finish your work, 5 minutes more. Ano yung 5 minutes? Gaano katagal yun? Sinabi ko na 5 minutes, di ka pa rin tapos. Hindi nga niya alam yung notion ng 5 minutes. No? Some children will not know that. So, ang gagawin ni teacher, kunyari may activity silang ginagawa. Pag nakarating na si Eliros dito, ibig sabihin, snack time na. So, titignan nyo ha, habang nagtatrabaho kayo. No? So, ikaw naman, convert mo yung distance na yan sa minutes. Kada minute, lipat mo 5 ganun. No? So, ayan. Okay, children. Naku, naglakad na si Ellie Rose. How are you doing? Matatapos na ba? Tignan ko nga. Sige, gawin ang gawin para matapos. Ganun. Tapos, okay, children, lumapit na naman siya. Yan. So, yung bata nagkakaroon ng idea. Okay? Kasi isa yan sa iniiyakan ng bata eh. Hindi pa siya tapos. Tapos na yung iba. Kasi iba yung notion niya eh. Oo. Yan. O iiyak na. Ngayon, kung talagang kulang yung oras, it's okay. No, you can do that. You know? Hindi natin masyado iyaharas. Except if the child has a lot of off-task behavior. Ay kaya pala hindi matapos, kinukulit lahat ng kaklase. Iba yon. That's managing. You have to manage the behavior of the child. No? Pero kung talagang gawa naman siya ng gawa, mabaga lang, then we can assist. You know, we can scaffold and all of that. Okay? So, ang maganda niyan, laging umaandar yan hanggang makauwi. So, nakikita nila, it's like a journey. No? It's the teacher. Well, maybe, later on, if they understand the concept, one can be the timer. Yeah. Kung nagkakaroon na siya ng notion ng gaano ang 5 minutes. Isa pa, ang sasabihin ninyo, may malaki kayong clock sa school. Titignan nila, i-compare nila kung pareho na. Yan. Oo, kaya meron ito. Oh, malapit na ba? Teacher, malapit na. Oh, 20 na. And even without really explicitly teaching how to read the time, nakukuha nila kasi everyday use. Yes, yes. That's why, sabi ko nga, this got a good grade for me because it's a timer. It shows the routine. It can teach the time. No? It can show the process. You begin the class day, and you end it. You say goodbye, and then we see each other again. So the regularity and all of that. Okay? So this is the daily routine chart. So that is in the temporal. The affective is the psychological climate in the classroom. So that is a very important part. In fact, the 80 slides following are mostly on the affective environment. No? Because establishing a community of learners will happen if they feel safe if they feel secure in your classroom. No? Yan. Hindi sila takot. Hindi sila takot sa teacher o takot sa kaklase. Nararamdaman nila na sila ay mahal. Sila ay kabilang sa class. Kaya pag meron awareness ang teacher, magiging maganda ang samahan sa classroom. Okay? So that is the affective environment. How do you start the affective? How do you build the affective environment? Who is the crucial factor here? The teacher. The personhood of the teacher. It's very important. No? Napakadali nung physical sa kanung temporal. Turuan mo lang gumawa ng poster, turo mo lang yung strategy, pero yung affective, napakahirap. Yung teacher na nagbabato ng libro, nag-iitsa, hindi naman bato, itsa nung mga work, wala, kulang yun sa affective, right? No? That is why, when you look at it, you want to establish the affective environment, you start with the characteristics of successful teachers. No? Okay? Yan. Why are some teachers more successful in developing well-managed classrooms? Ang sagot, dahil sa personality nung teacher. No? Kaya ang teacher mini-mentor. No? May proseso ng pagpapalago ng pagkatao. Right? No? Kaya nga sa pre-service, talagang the teaching profession, tinuturo ang character ng teacher, no? Yan. Unang-una, optimistic teachers have classrooms filled with optimistic children. Hooray! Naku naman, kung yung teacher nakasimangot, oo, madami tayong gagawin ngayon. Huwag kayong magulo, ha? Ay, nako, pagka ganitong naiinis ako. Huwag kayong, di ba? Wow! No? So tandaan nyo, an optimistic teacher will create optimism in the classroom. With children, you don't have to say it. They will feel it. With your actions, how do you touch them? How do you look at them? No? Ito, nakalimutan ko sabihin. Pag ang teacher sa kindergarten, ay alam nyo, kailangan healthy. Lalo na ang tuhod. Bakit? Eye level. You respect the children by going to their eye level. Hindi parati siyang nakaganon sa'yo. Kaya even bulletin boards, if they are for the children, it should be the eye level of the children, not of the adults. They're the ones who need to see it. The alphabet, oh, way up there in the heavens. No? Dapat siya sa makikita ng height ng bata. No? So that is part of the classroom setup. Okay? It takes a big heart to help shape little minds. Really. It does. No? Okay? So, how do we define qualities of effective teachers? No? Successful teachers, ayan, kita nyo, application, they're simply applications of the DAP. They understand child development. They are patient. They possess gentle demeanor. No? Lahat ng mga naging estudyante ko, kahit 6 years ago or what, pag nakita kami, ma'am, gentle demeanor. Okay? There are people that naturally have gentle demeanor. But a good teacher would be malumanay. Merong ganyan eh. Eh kung hindi tayo ganyan, karirin natin. Kasi ang bata matatakot. No? Oo. So, that's the magic word. Gentle demeanor. Yung pag-itsa ng workbook, that's a rude demeanor. It's not gentle. Why do you have to be so rude? Recognize children's varying development timetables, willing to assist children when they need help. Okay? They take the time necessary to explain the rules to children. We have discussed that. Are able to communicate well with the parents. You have to also tell the parents what you are doing in school so they can follow up. are self-confident and well-organized, plan interesting activities for children, and they are fun-loving. No? So the teachers, they do their jobs. No? And teacher Ina would come to me, "Naku, you know this little boy, she knows the details. And she smiles about it." No? Ako sabi ko, wow, ang sarap. Kasi talagang concerned siya dun sa mga bata. Alam niya ang mga kwento, no? At kinukwento sa akin. That is the sort of attitude that we want to develop in teachers. They're fun-loving. They really love the children. They're concerned with them, no? Yan. Terrific. Ayan, sinasabi ko, energetic, able, cheerful, hardworking, no? Those are the important traits of the teacher. You challenge your teachers to really develop this in themselves. And when they know how important their job is, they will embrace that. No? Especially the word enthusiastic. If you look at the word enthusiastic, it came from the word entheos. Theo is God. It is inspired, empowered by God. So it's one thing to be excited, but it's another thing to be enthusiastic. No? So you can share this to them. No? And in the end, if they're able to do that, they will be truly remarkable. Yan, yan. Nakita nyo yung second to the last bullet? Nasabi ko na yon. Are physically active, willing to get down, literally, to the level of the children. Okay? So it's an ongoing process. No, you cannot say you have this poster, it's going to work right away. It's an ongoing process. You keep on seeing what will work. No? But it has lifelong results. If you're able to teach children to follow, no? Hopefully they take it with them as they grow. Okay? And as we said earlier, some children are more challenging than others. And both teachers and children will have bad days occasionally. No, may ganun talaga, kabait-bait na bata, pero ngayon, naku, maligalig. No, nangyayari talaga yon. Another issue, some teachers, no, instead of showing respect for children, they have negative comments, they yell, they're sarcastic. No? So, let us be aware of that. Sometimes it's nothing to us, but you see, it affects the self-concept of the child. No? So please do not do name-calling. Yan. Children need the same respect that adults share with one another. Respect begets respect. So, as I said this morning, it is really a community of learners. We respect our teachers. Teachers respect us. Teachers respect the children. So, everyone. No? Kasi we also catch the way we talk to the teachers. Okay? Another, being sensitive to the needs. No? Children love to... What's the child doing there? Move. They love to move. No? Ay, hindi pa... Ayan, konting move lang siya. Ayaw kasi siyang pagalawin ng teacher. Sa kindergarten, kapag mga 30 minutes na silang hindi gumagalaw, parusa na yun. Because they love to move. So, katulad natin kanina, oh, sumayaw, tapos yung fingers, yung ganon. Kasi kailangan ng brain nila yun eh. Their brains need them to move. No? So, it's part of their characteristics. They like to move. No? So, we should answer those needs. Marami kayong mga finger plays, di ba? Pag nakita natin, oh wow, they're gone. They're not listening anymore. Then you start a finger play. You start open, shut them. Open, shut them. Or something else. No? To get everyone to join. Halimbawa, magdadasal na. No? Sabi mo, oh, we will pray. Praying hands na. Pray. Pinagano mo yung nandito. Yung nandito naman ang nagbatukan. No? Magpipray na nga. So, meron kang pwede sa'yo mo. My hands are rolling, rolling, rolling. My hands are rolling just like this. Then sabi mo siya, ikaw, anong gusto mong action? My hands are waving, waving. And then, pag mga nakatatlo na sila, sasabihin mo, my hands are praying, praying, praying. My hands are praying just like this. In the name of the Father and of the Son. Diretso mo na yon. Kasi napaganan mo na sila. At saka makikita na nila yun. No? And then, may creativity pa yan. No? Kanina, may creativity tayo dun sa DAP. Napansin nyo, hindi ko sinabi, oh, yung, although I sampled, but I did not say that we must develop, no? I asked them. So, if you do that, you can also ask them. Kung ano na sabihin niyan, drumming, drumming, no? Tapos tuwan-tuwa siya kasi siya yung nagsuggest nun eh. No? Pagka napagbigyan mo sila, babagalan mo rin. Katulad nung kanta natin kanina, bumagal, no? Towards the end. My hands are pretty. Babagalan mo rin. Just like this. Gagayahin mo rin. No? Praying hands. Nakaganon lahat yon. And then, magdadasal na kayo. Plan for a variety of choices so that they can be engaged in your classroom. Okay? Ayun, nakita nyo, organize large chunks of time, no, for children to play. Meron talaga kailangang panahon para sa paglalaro. Okay? Provide materials for creative expression. Develop spaces even for private time. But I notice for Filipino children, they don't like private space. Sa States talaga eh, they're so individualistic. Our culture very... Pag malungkot tayo, gusto natin may kasama, no? So that's not really so, ano, it's different for us. Schedule rest times for children. Water should be readily available, no? Understanding cultural differences, okay? Learn to know, share stories about one's culture, share ideas, thought and entertainment about the culture. No? Of the children in your class. Okay. Yon. So, some families mistrust the school if they feel that they are not supported or they're not really part of the school life. Yan. That's a beautiful saying. No? Every child in your class is someone's whole world. How can you disrespect? He's somebody's treasure. No? If we have that in mind, wow. Learn from mistakes. Yung bata kasi pag nagkamali, pag lagi yan lalo na napapalo sa bahay, iiyak ka agad pag nagkamali. Kunyari natalsikan ng paint yung uniform or nakabasag, iiyak. No? And we need to be really ready. Yan. Akala, ito yung example. Akala ng teacher nasaktan. Yung pala umiiyak kasi nabuhos niya yung paint sa sahig, no? Yan. Children make mistakes from time to time. When you react positively, children learn positive attitudes about accidents and mishaps. So makikita nila, okay lang ang accident, no? Minsan nangyayari yan kasi hindi natuturuan na pag nagkamali ka, i-admit mo, no? Oh, so, paano a-admit ng bata kung natakot na sa atin? Diba? Yan. So, there are also specific strategies for that. To help children recognize that mistakes are part of daily living. Okay, this is an important set of strategies. First, remain calm. Eh, baka ikaw pa, ay! Ganun, no? Ikaw yung unang, minsan yung teacher yung unang-unang nagre-react. Ay, bakit natapon? Sinabi ko na kasi. Whoa, blaming agad. So let's stop ourselves from that. No? Okay. Second, how will you react? React with concern, not blame. Because these are young children. No? Yan. Oh, these two. For young preschoolers, help them clean up their mess. Like 3-year-old, no? If they are bigger children, not just preschoolers, but graders, what will you do? Give them their opportunity to pick up after themselves. Teacher, kaya ko, let the child do it. Hindi natin, kasi ano niya yung redeeming, ano niya yun eh, bawi niya yun eh. No? So they know that they can clean. No? Kita nyo psychologically, paglaki nila, nagkamali ako, aayusin ko to. Even in emotional things, nagkamali ako, aayusin ko. Hindi ko tatakbuhan. You get what I mean? That's how crucial. Remember, we're engineering their brains. No? So little things like this, the teacher should process with the child. No? If there is a mistake. You see how important the young years are, no? The early childhood years. Okay? Use positive comments. Okay? Enlist other children's assistance. You see the community of learners there? No? Nahirapan siya magwalis, magdampot, halika, tulungan natin. So not only the teacher will help. Everybody will help. Okay? Eh, yung teacher naman, view your own mistake positively. No? Baka mamaya, nagkamali ka ng kuha ng books. Oh, how stupid of me. You get what I mean? Ay, ano ba naman si teacher? Wala sa sarili. You are also belittling yourself, no? So, do not model that. Because the children will also see that. So, you also react, oops, I did it again. Oops, I made a mistake. You say, okay, I'm going to correct it. No? You don't need to lambast yourself, you know, like belittle yourself. Okay? Yan. So you model it. Yan. Tingnan niyo yung bata sa gitna. Mm. Miss X noticed that a group of her children were playing in the home living center. She overheard Marisa yell to the other, "Stop that right now! You're in big trouble and I'm going to whip your butt." No? So, hindi magandang salita nung bata. Ano dapat ang reaksyon? No? Ano reaction ng teacher? Subukan mong gawin yan pag hindi ikaw ang hinampas ko. Oh, wow. Look at that response, right? Okay? If we are not aware, the teacher can actually say that. So, this is better. Because you'll get into a battle with a child. Especially if the child is upset. And then, inanuhan mo din ng upset ka rin. No? So that will really create a problem. So we really need gentle demeanor. Okay? Use consistent instruction. Always remind. Show sympathy. So it really takes a lot of character development in the teacher to be able to do this. Yan. And the routines in cleaning up, no? Showing where to put the pencils, markers. Okay? I can. Nurturing personalities. Young children are in the process of learning to control their emotions. Katulad ng sinabi ko sa inyo, nakabato ka agad ng sapatos, no? Yan. Children need teachers who feel comfortable holding and soothing children when their feelings erupt. So, yung personality ng pagiging loving, importante sa teacher. These are examples, no, of situations that upset children. Okay? And we have the corresponding strategy. If they are hurt, show tender, loving care. Yun lang eh. Yun lang. Malayo sa bituka yan. No, sometimes we say that. But for the child, of course, the child is hurt. No? They are confused. Hold the children close and talk to them. Sometimes it's just about a puzzle that they cannot do. No? So you can just help them. They are frightened. Ito. To them, their fears are real. So huwag mo sasabihin, natatakot ka dun? Eh, fear nga niya yun eh. No? So you explain, talk to them about their fears. If they are victimized, okay? Halimbawa, ayun, yung example. Binato ng sapatos, dumudugo. First reaction, go to the victim first. Express sympathy, then talk to the offender. Okay? Remind them of the rules of caring for one another. These are just the outline of how you will respond. Families are in conflict. No? How will you handle this? Talk to the parents. Do not try to say something that will make the child feel better. Kunyari, si daddy hindi na umuwi sa amin. Ganun, no? Alam, bata, they're very honest. They will really say that. Eh, ikaw naman, teacher. Tahan na, mama, yung gabi. Uuwi yun. Oh, wow. What is your guarantee? How did you know? Oo, kasi yung iba para lang maibsan. No? Oh, okay. I know you feel upset. Ganun lang. Ay, oo na. Malungkot, halika. Don't say anything. Halika dito. Ganun lang. Huwag ka mag-guarantee ng anything. Ay, oo, talaga yung nanay mo. Don't say anything, even if you know the parents or what. No? Because, oo eh, may issue na nga siya. Naniniwala sa'yo yung bata. Pag may sinabi ka, maniniwala sa'yo yun. No? So, talk to the parents. Mami, may sinabi po sa akin si ano. Affected po siya. Ganon. Okay? They experience separation. Tell children that their loved one will return if, ano yung separation na yan? Hindi yan separation na malaki. First day of class yan. Yung sinasabing separation dyan. No? Uuwi. Oo, yan. Uuwi. One technique, you can tell the parents to leave something to the child. Halimbawa, ito ang favorite hanky ni mommy. Keep it, ha? Give it to me when I come back. So, yung bata, hahawak dun sa panyo. Kasi, yun ang kanyang physical assurance, mommy will be back and I will give this to mommy. Okay? Yun yung ibig sabihin yan. Hindi yung naghiwalay. No? So, separation anxiety. Okay? Then, engage them in an activity. Alam nyo ba, yan ang pinaka-nakakaawa talaga. Yung first day of classes. Kasi maraming umiiyak, right? Ang magulang ganito, hindi pa ready ang anak ko, uwi na lang kami, no? So in the orientation, sinasabi namin sa kanila, Mami, we know how to handle crying children. Okay? Your child will cry. Some children will cry, some children will not. If your child cries, it's okay. It doesn't mean lesser siya dun sa hindi umiyak. Iba-iba lang po talaga ang bata. Ganyan sinasabi namin. No? Magtutulungan po tayo. Kasi may mga parents hindi talaga matiis. Oo. Ipo-pull out yung anak. You have to give the child the chance. Makakaya niya yun. One technique is ignoring. Ang sakit gawin yan. Pero believe me, it works. Ha? Kasi ini-express niya lang yung anxiety niya eh. Pagka sinabi mo na sa bata na, yeah, you know, we will work. Kasi paano naman si teacher? Kung hahawakan niya lang isang bata, eh maglilesson siya. Diba? So, hayaan mo lang. Pag nakita ng magulang yon, magre-react. Diba? Kailangan mong i-explain sa magulang. No? Ang technique doon, invitation. That's a strategy. Treasure, this chair is for you. When you are ready, you sit down and this paper are for you to color or cut, whatever the activity is. Nakakatuwa, kasi nakaya niya na eh. Oo, nakakatuwa. It's really the cooperation of the parents and the teacher and knowing the strategies, no? Nakakatuwa, mga first, ano nila yan eh, trials in life, di ba? Na-hurdle niya, kaya niya sa buhay, no? Yan, so it's really so good, no? Yan. Okay? So approach problems realistically, no? Tingnan mo yan, engage na engage yung bata sa sinasabi ng teacher, no? She can really see the teacher is listening and is concerned, no? Do we do that? Do we establish that connection with each child? No? Ako naniniwala kahit marami ang bata. Pag kinausap ka, tignan mo siya. No? Yan. I think that is really possible. If the child feels that the teacher loves them, cares for them, the child will be motivated to learn. No? Importante talaga yon. Now, how do you enjoy the children? Get to know the family. Have a birthday board. Di pala ako nakapagdala ng birthday board. No? Yan. Anticipate the birth of siblings. Greet children personally and decorate. You know, in Washington, D.C., when we were trained to observe schools with their accreditation forms, alam nyo ba nakakagulat? Hindi malaking points kung maganda yung classroom, may projector, mga ganyan, hindi. Highest score is adult-child engagement. What's the term? Adult-child, there's a term, discourse. Adult-child discourse. Paano makipag-usap ang teacher sa bata at ang bata? Yung interaction, ang laki ng points nun. No? So, ang nag-o-observe, umiikot, tinitignan paano makipag-usap ang teacher. Natural ang flow. That's the biggest guarantee of a quality program. And I think we really need to work on that. So, you communicate with the parents, laugh with the children, no? Enjoy the class. Diba? Yan. If they are bored, the classroom is dull, no? Wholesale change. Ibig sabihin, wag naman yung buong classroom mo papalitan mo, no? It could be that there are only certain things that you need to change. Kasi pag binago mo rin lahat, ma-overwhelm. The children will be overwhelmed. Okay? So you think of a way that would spark. You just add something in your classroom. Like a few toys, a new set of puzzle, few books, have a classroom pet, like what I showed you earlier. Introduce new songs in the CD. Okay? Yan. Have little field trips. One of the things presented in the last conference of NAEYC in Georgia, that was in Georgia, is the technique of videotaping and audiotaping children. While the children are working, you can ask a classmate to videotape, no, with your cell phone. And then you let the child watch it with you. It's a technique that they do in reading. You get what I mean? Parang micro-teaching siya, pero ang bata ang nakakapanood sa sarili niya. That is now a technique that they do in the States. You can also observe that. Okay? Now, how will the teacher do this all? Madali ba yung na-discuss ko? Kalmado siya. Alam niya mag-respond, no? Teachers must keep their emotional lives in check to establish positive relationship with children. Pag marami rin siyang issue sa buhay, napakahirap din. No? I always tell my students, the children have such pure souls, they can see right through you. Right? They know if you are sincere to them. They know if you are concerned. But if the teacher is concerned with a lot of things, hurting, unforgiveness, no? It's very hard to be so good to the children. No? So that's another area. Okay? Teachers have influence in children's lives. Adult negativity, not caring for emotional health. No? Diba? If we are troubled, that will affect the way we deal with children. Keep life in balance. Yan. As much as possible, keep the family life stable. Tinatanong nila ako, anong measure ng success? Successful ka ba? It's not career anything. It's still the children. It's still the relationship in our lives that matters so much to us. Our relationship with God. No? Good friends. Ability to laugh. Enjoyment of living. And you will see, alam nyo ba there is research? Pag nakarinig ka ng tumatawa, gusto mo ring tumawa. They put in the brain scanner, pinarinig nila yung tumatawa. Yes. So it's good to have a very cheerful faculty room. Yan. Smile to children. No? Yan. Interest in the children. Yan, nakwento ko na yan kanina. Sympathize with children. No? Broaden understanding of the profession. I hope our day together will inspire you to be happier in your profession. Right? No? Getting to see all these things, being reminded of these things. Ayan, next, exercise. Ayan, ang mga talon-talon na yan. No? Very important for the release of endorphins. And stress reduction techniques, spirituality, kaya natin yon. Spirituality, as I mentioned earlier, very important for us to have our own devotion, prayer time. No? Time out. Relax. Go to the spa. No? That's very important. Go to a retreat. Okay? Step away from the children for a few minutes and take a deep breath. No? Huwag mo lang silang iiwan ng not supervised. No? But sometimes it's necessary to do that. Okay? So ito, just to summarize again, follow the time blocks, have a set of time blocks, but be flexible. There are times when you can be flexible. If you have special activities, have smooth transitions, as we said. No? Is there somebody who discussed transitions with you? Wala. Like kunyari, dismissal. All with blue ribbons may get their bags. May iba-iba kang paraan ng transition. Okay? Okay, have procedures ready. How do you pass the books? How do you get the crayons? All of that. Once you have procedures for everything, the class will go smoothly. No? Kasi pag ang bata, nag-misbehave, oh, I forgot to emphasize this. This is very important. When a child misbehaves, our paradigm, okay? Anong paradigm natin pag nag-misbehave ang bata? Automatic. Batang to talaga maldita. Tama? Minsan napapaganon tayo, no? Nagli-label kahit sa mind lang natin. Pasaway talaga tong batang to. We can shift that paradigm. Okay? This is so important. I tell my students in guidance, if this is the only principle you remember, it's worth taking, passing the guidance class. No? If a child misbehaves, the child is communicating to you. One, is there a need that is not met? Okay? E gutom pala eh. Inaantok. Pagod. O kudu, hindi, biro lang. No? Inaantok, pagod, gutom, nauuhaw. Kaya pala, is there a need? Wag kagad natin, sabihin natin sa teacher natin, wag kagad iisipin na, malditang bata to. Kasi pag ganun ang paradigm mo, remember what I discussed about paradigm? You act based on your paradigm. You see that lady who's so rude to the guy? Eh, the guy owned the cookies, right? So, ganun din. Malditang bata. Tigilan mo yan, ha? Ikaw, bibingo ka na. Diba? So, how is that? We forgot everything about classroom management. No? One, is there a need that has to be met? Second, is there something that I need to teach this child? Okay, what can I teach this child? Observe, bakit niya sinisipa yung blocks? Bakit niya sinisipa yung blocks? Kasi gusto niyang sumali. Gusto niya rin, pero hindi niya alam paano. Baka ayawan siya. No? So now you teach the child. Okay? Kasi if we just say something, it might not be addressing the need of the child. So now the child is really trapped. You see the predicament of the child. Because the teacher is always mad. Go back to your seat. See? So where will the child go? Okay? No? Okay? So, remember that. Okay? Use environmental cues.